on Saturday, there was quite a historic moment, and that was one of the largest gatherings of patriots, I think, that has ever happened in London.
Fuck off, you anti-Semitic prick.
So there were some foreign flags there, which seemed a bit strange to me. For a British patriotic thing, there was a Ukrainian flag and an Israeli flag, which I think was a bit weird. Also, a usual suspect turned up. Jeremy Corbyn, there he is, just in case there wasn't enough socialism at the event. The man himself turned up. I mean, when your opponents are a bunch of socialists and people flying Palestinian flags looking like a member of Hamas. You've got to feel like, well, the PR win is on our side, right?
It's just... You can get more wrong than Corbyn.
Of course, yeah.
I don't know. Please challenge me.
Thank you to every single person that's here today in the biggest ever political demonstration in the history of this country. No, absolutely no to war on Iraq.
I mean, I think it's challenge impossible.
I don't think there are many Jeremy Corbyn fans in our audience, to be honest.
Yeah, but there are other people. It just seems to me that he's consistently wrong on basically everything.
Yes, yeah. Correct.
Why are we spending £3.5 billion on a war that nobody wants? Thousands more deaths in Iraq will not make things right. It will set off a spiral of conflict, of hate, of misery, of desperation that will fuel the wars, the conflict, the terrorism, the depression, and the misery of future generations.
Narinda Kerr again said, absolute BS, I was there. It was far from welcoming and warm. I was petrified as a woman walking through.
I walked through the other march, Tommy Robinson's march, I don't know, maybe 20, 25 minutes. There was a lot of people drinking. We saw a lot of guys drinking cans of beer, and they were possibly drunk. I did feel scared. Why wouldn't I feel scared as a brown woman? Why would I feel safe in that environment?
What exactly am I doing? I'm standing with Israel today. Last time I came against
you. You're alive. That's bad enough. Fuck off.
Where they're singing anti-Islamic chants. I'm not Muslim, but I'm brown. Why would I feel... They didn't make me feel welcomed. But, you know, I'm not saying they would have attacked me either.
No, you're not escorting me. You're roughing me. That's around my neck. That's assault. Go away.
But I didn't feel safe. And you need to accept that, you know? And the other march, I did feel safe. It was inclusive.
Who opposes Tommy Robinson? We oppose Tommy Robinson. Who opposes Tommy Robinson? We oppose Tommy Robinson.
The other march, however, was really a safe space for all.
I was there. I know my feelings. And I don't like people like Michelle Dewsbury, whoever, Caucasian women coming at me, telling me my feelings are a lie or fake.
She's just saying, I was petrified as a woman. So there's no actual evidence to suggest that she was unsafe or anything. It was in her own head. And the final thing they asked Tommy about, which I thought was kind of amusing actually, was they asked him about Israel.
Break the Jew taboo, boys, let's break the Jew taboo. Just say the word, boys, break the Jew taboo.
This is a stitch up. This is a stitch up of the highest order. Yeah.
yes, make of that what you will. Whatever you make of Tommy Robinson, what you can certainly acknowledge here is that there are lots of concerning lines being crossed by people who are opposed to him that I think no reasonable, decent person should have to tolerate. And I think that if a president gets set where people like him can get persecuted in that way, it's only going to get worse. And eventually, it'll even get to the point where perhaps normal people will be persecuted in these sorts of ways.
If you're not guilty, why did you run, Tommy? Break the Jew taboo, boys, break the Jew taboo.